Thank you very much for joining us.
Nice to meet you finally in person.
Yeah, really appreciate your time, and it's good to have you on our media sector today.
I feel like I know you. I've talked to you on radio, I know you from Facebook, and now I get to meet you.
Cool, thank you. Oompher is all about inspiring people to achieve extraordinary things. So who and what during your life and career has inspired you?
Well, I guess it started with my father, because he was a journalist, and he was a very interesting man. He was one of that generation that left school very, very early as a teenager, and he had to really work incredibly hard to work his way up. So Dad had this amazing work ethic. And when I was a Herald reporter, he'd come in and say, when I was, my 20s, he'd come in and say, what have you written today? I'd go, oh, I've written the front page lead. Huh. So why did you write that intro like that? And I'd go, well, actually, I didn't quite do that. I wrote this, a substitute. Oh, that's all right. And so he was, he set a really high standard and a really high bar. But the thing with Dad was, he was really good to all people. You know what I mean? He wasn't one of those, I do not like people who think that they can treat people who they perceive to be in positions of less power poorly. And Dad had often come home with printer's ink on his shirt sleeves because he'd help get the print run out. And I always thought that was really cool. Yeah. So he's certainly one of my early heroes, I guess. And then within the work environment, really lucky that I had people along the way who were generous enough and saw something in me to help me and encourage me and mentor me and just give you the breaks and the opportunities.
Yeah, and Sir Paul Holmes was one of those people.
Absolutely.
Did you learn a lot from him?
Gosh, yes. I mean, to be lucky enough to be the stand-in and kind of follow along in the footsteps of our greatest broadcaster was extraordinary for me. You probably realise more afterwards than at the time.
Okay.
But yeah, just an extraordinary guy to know and to have had the pleasure of working alongside.
Okay. So you've been involved in journalism for a number of years now, having entered the industry in 1979 at the Bay of Plenty Times and then doing shows such as Holmes, Close Up, and now Q&A. What have you learned? What are some of the key things you've learned about journalism?
Work hard. Listen to people. As a presenter, I think you really need great producers, and I've been blessed with having many of them because they save you from yourself often. But I think the thing is, I had a really lucky time in television that I joined TVNZ. So my career started in print, and I went to the Bok Times, which was a really good thing to start on a smaller paper. Then I went to the Herald, and then I was overseas for a bit, and then I joined TVNZ. And I just joined at a massive growth time. So you were one news reporter, then I was the Australia correspondent, so I was the first correspondent out of New Zealand. So that was fantastic that they opened that up at that time. Then I came back, and I was the first host of Midday News, which we started. Then it was breakfast with Mike Hosking. So I got all these lucky firsts, and then following along being Sir Paul's stand-in for about 15 years. So it was just this really fantastic, I think of them as golden days of New Zealand television. There was massive growth going on. I was the right age and stage to get those opportunities. But I think the thing is, I remember Sir Paul saying this when he retired from Newstalk ZB, he said, you get these amazing opportunities and then you work the hell out of them, and you do work incredibly hard. And it is really hard. I mean, I look at the breakfast host now, and you get up ridiculously early and you have to perform, and it is hard, but it is amazing also.
And did you always have that passion for journalism and people?
Well, I didn't really know what I wanted to do. I was drifting around, and I left school quite young. And then I worked in a jean shop for a year, which was kind of fun, and I learned lots of things. And I, about 2 weeks in, the guy threw me the keys and said, well, you can run the place. So I was like, okay. I was about 17 at that point. And then I, excuse me, then I didn't know what to do, really. Went to uni, dropped out, went and lived in Australia for a while, and then I thought, well, what can I do? I can write.
Yeah.
So I did a journalism course. So I fell into journalism, and it was because of Dad, really, because he was a journalist.
Yeah,
I thought, well, that looks pretty cool. I might do that.
Okay.
So there was never a grand plan.
Yeah, and more. Do you have more interest in the sort of radio, TV, or newsprint, or a bit of both? And
all of them. Like, they're all fantastic.
Yeah. What are the key differences in those?
Radio is incredibly immediate and intimate. So something can happen, you can be on the phone immediately talking to that person. Television has an incredible power of images, of pictures, looking to someone's face, looking to their eyes, you know, whatever. So that's got that real power of pictures. But it takes longer. It's very hard. You can't pick up the phone and do it immediately. Print, a whole other thing, because you get a depth. You get an analysis, you get thought that you can't get in those others so much. So you can spend your time reading a beautifully crafted piece of work and really enjoy the writing and the thought and that's gone behind it. So I love it all, actually. I really love all different ways of getting information.
Yeah, and do you consider yourself quite lucky to have experienced all of the
types? Oh, gosh, yes. Yeah, incredibly so. I went backwards. Print was a great place to start, and then I went straight to TV. Yeah. Most people probably have radio in the middle, and then I came to radio later.
Okay.
But it probably would have made it easier if I'd gone radio, TV. But I may have just stuck at radio because it's so cool. So it's all worked out as it should have.
Yeah, and would you have sort of different advice for those different three sort of industries? What are some key things you would pass on to people that would differ between, say, radio and TV?
No, I think it's the same sort of thing of honing your craft, of knowing what a story is, of connecting with people. Across all of that, all those mediums, across whether you're advertising, whether you're marketing, all of those things, we're all storytellers.
Yeah.
And it's about telling the best stories. I mean, your storytelling now with what you're doing, and it's about connecting with people through those stories. So yes, you use different tools to do it, but it's really important that you connect.
So you've got to have that passion for telling stories and passing them on in a good way. Okay. Just going back to what you were saying before about the hard work side of things, did that hard work, did you manage to find quite a good balance between your sort of personal life and work life, and was that quite challenging? Or
I was incredibly lucky because when my boys were little, I was doing those big sort of high profile jobs. They are quite short days as presenters. You're not doing a 12-hour day. You work often both ends of the day, and you can work from home, but your time in the studio is relatively short. So I feel I was incredibly lucky that I managed to be mother and have a career at the same time. So it did actually work out incredibly well.
Okay, and is there quite a lot of behind the scenes work in terms of researching and stuff as well?
Yeah, and I now host a once a week show on Q&A on Sunday mornings, but I stay in the news cycle.
Yeah.
I start my day online looking at the website, the various news websites.
So you're always going to be on top of it, seeing what's going on.
You've got to know, you just stay in that news cycle.
Okay, and are there any bits of the newsroom that you don't enjoy? Is it a pretty grueling environment?
I mean, where I'm at now, it's... No, you see, I like that. I like the kind of do it now and the...
Yep.
You know, I'm especially thinking about radio because that can be pretty frenetic and things can happen and you're like, just do this interview now, and literally you've got 30 seconds to think, oh, okay, what am I asking? Now, I kind of like the immediacy and kind of slight madness of it sometimes. I find that exciting.
Okay, great.
Because it's challenging.
Yeah, and do some people not cope with that so well? Or
you learn to cope with it. You start, though, I mean, I remember when I was a student... And I was sent to the a Christchurch newspaper at the time, and there was some story about, I don't know, the wolves had got out at Arana Park. I had no clue where to start writing that story. But you learn, and I said, but I just asked somebody, and they said, oh, just start writing like this. And I was like, okay, thank you.
Okay.
Once you're away, you're away.
Yeah.
But yeah.
And today with Q&A and News Talk ZB, when you fill in there, is the spark still there for you? Do you still really passionate about it? Do you sort of jump out of bed and love doing it?
Yeah. The jumping out of bed, before 4 in the morning, not so much jumping, I'd have to say. It's more of a crawling out of that hour. I wouldn't be doing it if I didn't have the passion.
Yeah.
And I think the thing about those is that it's unfiltered. And I think when there's so much noise around at the moment and so much information that isn't necessarily reliable, to know that you're hearing... I'm hearing from Jake this morning, and I'm actually hearing your words, so I can ask any question, but it's unfiltered, it's you talking, same on a television interview.
Yeah.
So it gives people, you make up your own mind.
Mm.
Viewers, listeners, it's up to you. You take from this what you will.
Okay, great.
So it's a great way of getting information across.
Yeah, absolutely. And what's left for you now? Do you want to do quite a bit more work?
What's left for me now?
In your business, Susan Wood Communications, are you doing quite a bit with that now?
I do quite a bit of video production around that. So that's just a skill, because I obviously was a journalist for a long time, but I've taught myself new skills in terms of producing, directing. So there's real challenges for me in that, and I really do enjoy that because, again, it's just storytelling.
Yeah.
It's storytelling and communicating.
Okay.
So, yeah. It's hard to know. I've never been a big, here's the 20-year plan.
Yeah, sort of a journey person and just see what comes.
I've got a little bit. I've got more of a plan than I've ever had before. And you do realise that as you hit my end of the career, time is running out. But you also go, okay, I'm going to make the most of every moment of it and not worry too much about it.
Great. Okay, so now I've just got a few quick fire questions to finish. Just to sort of recap, what would be your top three bits of advice for anyone wanting to get into media and journalism?
Think about why you want to do it. Because I don't think it's you should be doing it because you want to be a star. I think you should be doing it because you're really interested in people and their stories.
Yeah.
And that was the real strength that Sir Paul had, that he would sit down and listen and connect with people. So you really need to think about your motivation behind it. That's one piece of advice. Don't expect to make a fortune in it, because you won't.
Yeah.
But if you really want to do it, I was talking to a young woman the other day who'd done a law degree, and she said, I know it's what I want to do. And I said, you sure? And she is now doing it. She's in radio. But if you really want to do it, go for it and work hard.
Okay, great. And is there any bit of advice that you wish you were sort of given in those early days that would have been really helpful in your early days of your career that now you sort of keep at the forefront on your day-to-day life?
Yeah, probably not to be so tough on myself, but that's all right. That's just my nature. So.
Yeah. Okay, great. So looking back over your career as a whole, what would you consider to be some of the key highlights? What have you absolutely loved?
Working on Holmes for all those years was just an amazing experience, because you realise now what an enormous part it was of the New Zealand culture and psyche. There was, we would be broadcasting to 1 in 3 New Zealanders. And when you're thinking there's kids in that number as well, it was a massively impactful show that changed the conversation around really important things, like Eve Van Graaffest, who had HIV AIDS, which she'd contracted as a baby through blood transfusion. And through Paul's attitude towards that, there was a real acceptance when she'd been jumped out of Australia. So you could really make a significant and meaningful difference.
Yeah, brilliant. And to finish, Susan, well, can you please look down the camera and tell us, what are your wise words for the people of New Zealand?
I think it's certainly a matter of being kind and being kind to yourself and others. I think kindness is a quality that is, we just don't seem to be very kind to each other. We're mid-election cycle at the moment. And I'd like us to be a little kinder and nicer to each other, really.
Brilliant. Susan, thank you so much. Cheers.